Over the past few years, refined metal has dipped into extremely low values, dipping to a value of around 3 cents, similar to that of a crate. Now, this wasn't always the case, and there's various reasons as to why this is all happening, which I will discuss and give an answer to a topic that YouTubers have been milking for years. Before we discuss why prices of metal are dropping, we need to understand what gave it value and why it is that we trade between refined metal and keys so often. Trust me, it's important. You see, long ago, when crates used to drop instead of cases, players could use one universal key, most of the times at least, to unlock a continuous series of crates. Using that key, they could unbox multiple different items, like paint, weapons, strange parts, and strange weapons. But something stood out more than anything in those crates, which still proves to be beloved to this day. Hats. Not only do players love them, but it also rakes in a heckload of money for Valve.
Thanks.
So it made enough sense for them to keep adding more crates with cosmetics. Another method of obtaining hats was through refined metal. Now, sure, you could use metal to craft weapons, but nowadays you're losing value in most of these crafts if you aren't crafting some sort of rare reskin in the game. Crafting hats, on the other hand, was just a bit more reliable, and not only getting the chance to profit and have something in your inventory you might actually consider using, but if you were one of the first to craft a new hat after it was added to the crafting system, it would be marked with a craft number on the cosmetic, which then made it a good incentive to use metal to craft hats. Because not only did a craft number make it more desirable for people to show off, but also created a competition between multiple players to craft these cosmetics using refined metal or craft hats in the process, creating a niche trading scene for multiple collectors and investors to obtain these first craft cosmetics. Overall, having keys and refined metal as trading currency was convenient. If you wanted to trade up to an unusual or something else relatively pricey, keys and metal were the stable option because of their value and were easily tradable because of their unique use. So now we know why keys and refined metal are valued and highly traded. But why has the value of refined dipped so low over the past few years? Let's travel back to a few years ago. The date is July 2nd, 2015. Valve released a major yet somewhat controversial update. The gunmetal update. While they decided to launch a few much-needed weapon balances for certain weapons, they also introduced cases, adding their first skins into the game, which you could receive as a reward from the sort of battle pass system they released that would last for the duration of 3 months. Or you could also unbox skins with a small chance of receiving an unusual weapon, from using a case key to open the cases that were in the drop system at the time. You see, before the update, players had a limited amount of weapon customization in terms of appearance, and were limited to bot killers, Australiums, and reskins of weapons. And with war paints being added, a few players hopped on to grab some cool skins, while some others hated the idea, with some trying to start a boycott against the whole idea of war-painted weapon skins. Eventually, time passed, and it's not too uncommon for players to get excited about a new shiny warpaint that comes out each update. Now you might be thinking, well, the gunmetal update doesn't sound bad at all. They gave us cool new stuff to use in an update, right? Could use one of those right now. Sure, but it was slightly controversial as players started to wonder about the direction the game was headed in, as it was around this time that CSGO's unboxing and gambling content hit its peak. And for Valve, this may have been their way of maximizing profits on the whole case unboxing trend, followed by influencers with gambling sponsorships that were going on around at the time. But this update was only just the beginning, a precursor to Valve's worst mistake, causing them to devalue their keys and refined metal especially. Many of you will probably already know what update I'm talking about, as it not only changed the gameplay of the game entirely, but it led to the start of what seemed like an inevitable doom to refined metal. Meet your match. Now, I'm not going to go into the whole concept of the update itself and how much it disrupted the prior TF2 matchmaking experience, but rather the method of unboxing from this point forward. And by that, I mean they never produced a crate since. The problem with this is that now you can't craft new cosmetics with refined metal that would have otherwise been normally introduced into the crafting system, lowering the use and demand of refined metal, leaving less reason to use the crafting system as a metal sink, thus significantly lowering the value of refined metal over time, as you would only be able to craft the same set of cosmetics, most of which price around one refined metal. And because of how newer cosmetics unboxed from cases are tiered and tinkered with different rarity, there are certain cosmetics and items you'll probably forget exist or are too expensive to bother buying when there are many more alternatives to choose from. Now, there's only a few pros I could see from Valve continuing this style of unboxing. Number 1. Workshop creators can expect to make more money compared to the old method of unboxing crates. Along with how workshop creators receive a percentage of sales they make on case keys from the Manco store, the trade-up feature would require you to unbox more cases or to purchase similarly tiered cosmetics to proceed with the trade-up, making Valve more money. And let me tell you, Valve has always loved making money for themselves and giving a teeny portion of it back to the community, which is only fair after making the millions of dollars per year off of crate and case openings. Number 2. Older cosmetics will be easily affordable. Another possible pro to the new style of unboxing, depending on the way you look at it, is that while refined metal can't craft the latest hats from all the cool cases, it can still be used to craft older but perhaps still desirable cosmetics. And with how you would be crafting the same cosmetic list for years, those cosmetics will devalue faster over time compared to the cosmetics in cases that you cannot craft, which then makes older cosmetics more accessible for all players to afford and wear. Players would use to scrap loads of weapons to be able to afford a hat, but now it's been easier than ever because of its low value from how its use has been milked for years. And because of that, it is 3 cents, which then means you'll need a lot more refined metal if you ever plan up on trading up to the value of a key. Now, what could Valve do to improve the economy of refined metal? Well, it's actually not too difficult to come up with the solutions to boost the value. Generally, we want to make both of these desirable and have a sort of use in the present, increase the demand, etc. So here's what the Team Fortress 2 devs could do to fix this up. Create a metal sink, aka something that consumes metal for something players may desire. Depending on how much demand refined metal receives, we may see an increase in price. Surprisingly enough, Valve has already introduced temporary metal sinks in the past. For example, during the Love and War update, or you may know it as the Bread update, had it to where you could craft 3 random cosmetics into what was known as a bread box. This bread box contained several items relating to TF2's short film expiration date, with a rare chance of receiving a strange variant. This may not have affected the price of metal as much as it did very cheap cosmetics on the market that were probably used in this crafting recipe, but if presented today, it could lift the price of cheaper cosmetics. Or they could do something like a rare drop whenever you craft something, similar to how golden wrenches used to drop as a result of crafting a random item. Most crafting recipes take up metal, so that could boost up the demand for metal if Valve were to do something similar again. I've also come up with my own personal idea, which would be to introduce new limited time craftable cosmetics exempt from class crates in the drop system, only being obtainable through the hat crafting system. It would cause a lot of players to dump the refined into trying to get these new cosmetics that were added to their crafting list. And then after a few months, remove those cosmetics from the crafting system and add in some new cosmetics. Then repeat the cycle. This could add value to hats already in the crafting system if players were to recraft 2 cosmetics for a new one. All of this would add a trading scene for these limited cosmetics, and many players would be eager to get their hands on something rare, especially with how cheap refined metal is right now. These ideas would at least let Valve continue their cosmetic and Warpaint case shenanigans, and at the same time, improve the value of refined for those who want to have an easier time trading up to a key and an actual use for the mass amount of refined metal flow in the market right now. But that about wraps up why keys and refined metal have dropped in price lately. If you enjoyed this video, hit like. I'm trying to hit 10k, so a subscription is always appreciated. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.